My name is Demigates G. Morales. Please call me Orange. Welcome back, guys, to my YouTube channel, Orange and Mother Gemz. As I promised you guys last Sunday, remember that I will give prizes for the first 10 who could send me their pictures after doing the 3 given worksheets. And here are our top 10 task achievers. Let's watch them. Top 10 task achiever is Baby Blue and top 9 is Dappy. They both from NHA Bangkal and my cousins. Our top 8 and 7 are Ate Rachel and my BFF Caleb, both from Katitipan. Our top 6 and 5 are also siblings Martin and Rafa of Central Park, Bangkal. And our top 4 and 3 are another siblings from Bago Aplaya, Ate Dian Faye, and Dan Lloyd. Lastly, but our top 1 and 2, of course, siblings again, Ate Mia and Kuya Micah. Congratulations to all of you, Baby Blue, Dappy, Ate Rachel, BFF Caleb, Martin, Rafa, Ate Dian Faye, Dan Lloyd, Ate Mia, and Kuya Micah. Good job, guys! Next month again! Wow, congratulations, guys! Are you happy with your prizes? We also have 4 best in memory verse, guys. Let's watch them.
Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created heaven and the earth.
Go.
Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. Genesis 9:13. I have set my rainbow in the cross. It will be the sign of the covenant between me and the earth.
Hello, Orange. I'm here to support you.
Go.
Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. Genesis 9:13. I have set my rainbow in the clouds. It will be the sign of the covenant between me and the earth. That's all. Thank you.
Dean Micabora here. I am now ready for the 3 Bible verses. Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
Go.
John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Genesis 9:13. I have set my rainbow in the clouds. It will be the sign of the covenant between me and the earth. That's all.
Wow! You did all it well, guys! I will also show you guys that I memorized the 3 Bible verses. Let's recite it all together. If you don't want to recite it, it's okay. But I will also close my eyes. If you don't want to close your eyes, it's okay. But if you want to close your eyes, it's still okay. Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. Genesis 9:13. I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it will be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. Wow, we all did it together. And you already have your prizes. Can I have one for me too? Thank you, Mama, for giving me these prizes. I will just place them here for now. And here is for Ate. There you go. Don't forget, guys, Jesus is always present among us. Let us be grateful because Jesus loves us. Please don't forget to subscribe, guys. Thank you, and I love you all. Next week, my online class will start, guys. However, I will still be here with all of you guys to share with you some exciting and meaningful activities we do during our Sunday school. Now let us start our fourth episode. Called God's Promise to Abraham.
Long after the flood, people on earth made a plan. We will build a great city with a tower right up to the heavens, they said. Let's live together always. Everyone spoke the same language. God wanted people to live all across the world He had made. So He did something special. Suddenly, groups of people spoke differently. God gave them new languages. Those who spoke the same language moved away together. Perhaps people became afraid of others they could not understand. In this way, God caused people to fill different countries. The city they left was called Babel, which means confusion. Years later, in a place called Ur of the Chaldees, God spoke to a man named Abram. Leave this land, God commanded. Go to the land I will show you. Abram obeyed. God led him to Canaan. His wife Sarai and nephew Lot went with him. In Canaan, both Abram and Lot became rich. They had large herds of cattle, and there was not enough pasture for so many animals. Lot's herdsmen quarreled with Abram's herdsmen. Let there be no trouble, Abram said. We will separate. Lot, you take first choice of the land you want. Lot chose a great grassy plain dotted with cities and villages. It looked good, but the cities were very wicked places. After Lot left, God spoke again to Abram. I will give all the land of Canaan to you and your children forever. Abram and Sarai had no children. How could God keep His promise? Three men from God came to Abram and Sarai.
You'll have a baby soon, they said.
Sarai laughed. She did not believe God's message because she was 90 years old. God told Abram he would now be called Abraham, father of many, and Sarai would be Sarah, princess. God also told Abraham he would destroy the two wicked cities of Sodom and Gomorrah. Abraham's nephew, Lot, lived in Sodom with his family. Lot believed
God's warning when it came, but his daughter's husband refused to leave Sodom. How tragic! They didn't believe God's word. Only Lot and his two daughters made it to safety. Fire and brimstone fell upon the wicked cities. Sadly, Lot's wife disobeyed God's warning and she looked back as she ran. She turned into a pillar of salt. The Lord kept his promise to Abraham and Sarah. They had a child in their old age. Just as God had said, how they rejoiced when Isaac was born. Perhaps Abraham also thought about God's promise to give him and his children the land of Canaan forever. God would keep that promise too. God always keeps his promises. Written by Edward Hughes and illustrated by Byron Unger and Lazarus. Adapted by M. Milot and Tammy S. Produced by Bible for Children, www.m1914.org. That is the end of the story. Did you like the story, guys? Yes? That's great! And lastly, guys, let us recite our Bible verse of this episode. Genesis 12:3. I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse, and all people on earth will be blessed through you. Let's do it again. Genesis 12:3. I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse, and all people on earth will be blessed through you. Let us now pray, guys.
Dear God, Father God, thank you for always loving and guiding us every day. We pray you will continue to protect all of us, especially against COVID-19. We pray also that you will bless those who are sick and no food. We love you and adore you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. I hope to see you again, guys, next Sunday for our episode 5. I hope you all are ready and excited for your first day of online class. Thank you so much, IBCP Katitipan family and Pastor Lito for helping me in my little ministry. Shout out to IBCP Dibongko and IBCP Indangan and all kids and young people out there. Thank you so much as well to all who keep sharing and watching my videos in Facebook. God will bless you more and more. And lastly, thank you for watching, guys. Please, please, please subscribe by hitting the red button and click the bell for more videos and leave a comment for videos you like me to do. And please don't forget to like this episode. Bye! See you all next Sunday! I'm gonna miss you all! Bye! Shout out to IBCP Tibongko and IBCP Tibangkang.